If you want to learn how to dribble like Messi, you have come to the right place. In this Ultimate Dribbling Skill tutorial, we will reveal all secret details about his unique technique. Now, why is dribbling such an important skill? Because players like Messi master the skill of dribbling to perfection, they have a lot of confidence when they have the ball. They have the courage to attack defenders and create new dangerous situations on the pitch. Great dribblers often make a big difference for their teams because they can outplay direct opponents, create space for themselves or teammates, create overloads, create opportunities, and of course, score goals. Dribbling is all about close ball control, beat the defender, and create space for a key pass or a scoring opportunity. Now, look how Messi combines these three elements. 1. Close ball control. 2. Beat the defender. 3. Create space for a key pass and a scoring opportunity. Let's move on and show you exactly how Messi is able to keep close ball control. We will reveal all details about his technique and show you simple drills to practice so that you can improve your dribbling skills right away. First of all, Messi is able to keep the ball extremely close to his body as he starts a dribble, almost as if the ball is glued to his feet. Let's start with the most fundamental dribbling skills to maintain ball control. This is dribbling with the outside of your feet. This style of dribbling allows you to build up more speed as your feet are already in a natural running position. You can start by touching the ball every step. Of course, everybody can do this, but to master dribbling like Messi, you have to take smaller steps and more touches. Besides the smaller steps and more touches, Messi also leans slightly forward with his sternum over or towards the ball. This helps him to balance while also generating extra forward momentum during his acceleration. By mastering this extreme close control, Messi is able to respond much quicker to the situation and make better choices. The next step is to practice accelerating. So from small steps and many touches with the defender close, Messi suddenly changes pace by playing the ball into space. You can practice this at home by starting with small touches and then accelerate by playing the ball more in front of you and touch it every 3 to 4 steps. Start slowly and once you get better, start to accelerate and sprint faster. 2. Low center of gravity. Watch how Messi keeps his knees bent to stay lower to the ground as his opponent. A lower center of gravity gives him better balance and makes it easier to stay on his feet as he changes pace and direction. By bending your knees loosely, you'll be able to make faster cuts, which is a huge advantage when you're getting past the defender. Practice to make sharper cuts while staying low and accelerate immediately after changing directions. Let's continue with 3, using both your feet. If you are able to dribble with both feet like Messi, you have more options to increase speed and thought of play in any direction the situation is forcing you. Anybody can develop the ability to use both feet in football. The drill we use for staying low is also perfect to train dribbling with both feet. So after a sharp cut, you can accelerate even faster by continuing with your other foot. This is also the way you develop fine muscles in both legs. For sure, it pays off to develop this as early and as much as you can, because there is a proven relationship between professional player salary and the capabilities to play with both feet. 4. Stay light on your feet. Staying light on your feet means moving around on your front foot, without the heels touching the ground. This way you can be extremely agile and react much quicker to situations. By staying light on your feet, your body also gets in an active state, which gives you a head start when responding to quick changes during gameplay. This is an easy improvement, but you have to be very disciplined to apply this in all close ball control situations. You can practice this by using the same drill. Besides staying low and use both feet, now also focus on moving on your toes. Let's continue with 5. Use your arms. Only with perfect balance, you will be able to dribble and control the ball like Messi. To create this perfect balance, Messi uses his arms actively. By keeping his arms a little wide, he can correct this balance during fast changes of direction. During sprints, Messi uses his arms to follow the rhythm of his legs. That is how he is able to gain more speed. When Messi is in a 1v1 situation, he uses his arms to cut off defenders. He keeps them at a distance and brings them out of balance when getting past them. We move on to 6. Keep your head up. To make the right decisions, you need to recognize opportunities and situations on the pitch. Messi does this by keeping his head up regularly, during his dribbles. Only by keeping his head up, he is able to respond effectively to the ever-changing situations. By practicing this a lot, you develop a natural feeling for the location of the ball without having it directly in your sight. In this drill, you can do this by looking up after each cut. Make it a habit to look up and scan the pitch every few seconds. Top players do this all the time. They know exactly who is open or where defenders are weak. With dribbling skills like Messi, you will be able to dribble your way out of the most difficult situations. We've come to the seventh part of Messi's close ball control technique, and that is using all parts of your feet. To surprise your opponent, you should be able to change direction at any given time. In order to do that, you must learn to control the ball with all parts of your feet. This means with your inside, outside, sole, heel, laces, and toe. An effective and fun way to practice this is by using 6 cones and forcing yourself to use all parts of your feet while maneuvering around and through the cones. Challenge yourself by not touching the cones. Remember to take small steps and a lot of touches. Stay low, use both feet, use your arms, and keep your head up while using all parts of your feet. Practice this regularly for increased ball feeling, and it will also make you more confident, faster, and creative in tight spaces. The final step in close ball control is to get faster. As you get used to all Messi's close ball control techniques, challenge yourself by executing your skills at a higher pace and under pressure from real opponents. As with all things in life, you have to keep practicing and work hard on further improvements to grow and get better and better. Messi already knew this at a young age. The best decisions aren't made with your mind, but with your instinct. The more familiar with the situation you become, the quicker, the better your decision will be. Thank you so much for sticking with us, and get ready for a full breakdown of Messi's most deadly skills to beat defenders. If you liked the video so far, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already done so. This would really help us to grow our channel and stimulate us to make more valuable content, as it takes a lot of effort to create these videos. Now, without further ado, let's move on and find out how Messi is able to beat defenders over and over again. Let's kick it off with a feint Messi uses. It's called the stop and go. Like most other typical Messi skills, the stop and go also starts by feinting his opponent. As you are dribbling with a defender at your side, pretend to stop and accelerate forward. And as soon as the defender delays and steps in, resume by accelerating in the original direction. You created a head start with just enough time and space for your next move. The second skill Messi uses is the zigzag dribble. The zigzag is an awesome skill to beat defenders for the refined and agile dribblers. It starts with a frontal confrontation. By changing directions multiple times in a short time span, you will force your opponent backwards and make him turn. This skill is very useful if your defender is large and less agile. It will bring your opponent definitely out of balance. Watch closely and wait for the right moment. As soon as you see that the defender is out of balance, accelerate in the space you created. Next up is La Croqueta. Messi often uses the Croqueta to beat 1, 2, or even 3 defenders in tight situations. This might be one of the best skills for real game situations, as it is very hard to defend. Let's take a closer look at how to perform the La Croqueta. The technique basically starts with a feint to confuse the defender. Once the defender is eager to take the ball, quickly push the ball with the inside of your foot over to the other foot. The timing and distance are very important. Time your push when the defender steps in. In order to make sure the defender has no chance when stepping in, the distance should be about 1 step away. Immediately as the ball reaches your other foot, touch it forward into space. If there is enough space, play the ball 3 to 5 steps into space. This gives you more momentum to build up speed. If there are more defenders around, take a softer touch about 1 to 2 steps ahead and prepare for your next move. Now, as with all moves, chase pace explosively like Messi to maximize the effectiveness. Now let's continue with the shoulder drop. The shoulder drop is by far Messi's most used skill to beat defenders. Its simplicity combined with perfect timing and explosive accelerations makes it very effective. Start to bring the defender into a distance so that he thinks he can conquer the ball. Then start dropping your shoulder in the opposite direction you want to move. Take also a strong fake step in the opposite direction you want to move. And besides fooling your opponent, this fake step will also give you a perfect grip to push off in the other direction. In the meantime, control the ball with the foot in the direction you want to accelerate. As soon as your opponent reacts, accelerate in the other direction. Messi performs this sometimes so fast and so subtle that it's hard to follow, and even while defenders know he will use this feint, they fall for it over and over again. So, if there's one skill to become a great dribbler like Messi, make sure to apply the shoulder drop. Let's move on with a nice variant, the shoulder drop combined with a chop. The shoulder drop chop is a perfect variant for if the defender doesn't fall for your shoulder drop feint. By mastering the shoulder drop chop, you will still be one step ahead. As soon as you notice the defender is onto you, you surprise him with a small chop over the leg he steps in with. As you might have noticed, Messi uses a lot of close ball control techniques in combination with his skills. Make sure to keep the ball underneath you, remain a low center of gravity, then get the outside of your foot under the ball and pull up your knee to lift the ball over your opponent's leg. Now push off hard with your other foot and jump over the defender's leg, and away you are. Next up is the cut and turn. The cut and turn is designed to lure your opponent away and to create space for pass lines and break defensive lines. As you approach your opponent, you suddenly cut off the ball and position your body between the ball and your opponent. This way you will take the ball out of his sight and make him search for the ball. He is forced to move along with you and has to react. Make him think he can get the ball, and just when he steps in, you pull the ball back and accelerate into space, like pushing the ball forward. Keep looking up to see the best options for your next move. Now that we have covered Messi's close ball control techniques and his skills to beat defenders, it's time to show you why Messi's dribbles make him the best player in the world. The purpose of Messi's dribbles is not to be selfish or to show off, but it is always to create unexpected situations and force the opponent to leave their defensive formations. This will create space in other zones on the pitch for his teammates. We have to point out that creating space is such a wide topic that we can do a complete video on this part of Messi's skills. But for now, we will give you a perfect understanding of why Messi's dribbles are so effective and why he is able to score so many goals and also provides so many assists. Let's take a closer look at the third step of learning how to dribble like Messi. After beating the defender, he looks for opportunities to take advantage of the overloads and or spaces he just created. For this part, we get back to one of the most fundamental close control skills that Messi masters, namely keep your head up. Because Messi is continually scanning the pitch, he knows exactly where his teammates and opponents are. He processes this information quickly and uses it to analyze the tactical space. Then he decides how to beat the defender and create space for a killer pass and break the defensive lines of the opponent. In this example, we use the skill cut and turn. Watch how luring your opponent away opens up space between the two central defenders. You just learned all techniques to dribble like Messi, by keeping the ball close, beating defenders, and creating space for key passes or scoring opportunities. If you want to dribble like Messi, you also have to practice like him. To help you out, we created a PDF with all drills and step-by-step explanations of how you can learn to master dribbling like Messi. We've put a link in the description where you can download the PDF. Make sure to check out our other videos, and if you haven't already done so, please subscribe and like this video. We really appreciate it, and it encourages us to make more awesome videos for you guys. Thank you for watching, and see you next time. As always, enjoy practicing, and remember, your skills, your future.